When the morning comes, they ain't humble enough. When the morning comes.
I just looked at my wrist, I got time today.
Ride with the mob, alhamdulillah.
She can get gangster, we can keep it cordial. How you wanna go back?
How you wanna go?
I'm addicted to it, I know I am.
I know I am.
I'm addicted to it.
It's the mob, so you gotta get initiated. If you a mob, then you gotta make an issue. Pass the
But y'all think by doing all this shit behind the scenes and gathering together that y'all was gonna get rid of me, and somebody fucking lied. Cause y'all not. Y'all sent somebody before. And then every time y'all try it, everyone that tries it learns the hard way. I'm chosen. I'm a chosen one. I'm not going nowhere until I fuck I want to go somewhere.
Period.
You're like, yo, what the fuck is it gonna take to get rid of this bitch? You can't get rid of me, bitch. I'm not going nowhere. I'm not going no fucking where.
What is it? What is it?
Yeah, we finna set it off in this motherfucker.
Yeah. They ain't gonna like you. They ain't gonna like me. I've been getting to the money. Everybody mad. I think I'm getting too much money. Everybody mad. Same old nigga from the block. Same old nigga with the pot. The same old nigga from the trap. Everybody hated on him, then he bounced right back. I done spent a whole lot of time overseas. Doubling my money, cause you know I want cheese. I've been in my hometown playing with the keys. When they fell off the boat, yeah, I'm fucking about the lease. I know it's a whole lot of niggas that was hating. I know it's a whole lot of bitches that was taking. So I shut the niggas up, bitches feeling us. I was doing what I was sick, so I had to stay patient. Taking over summer, nigga, tell me what's the bid. Hurt you sleep, tough a nigga, tell me what it is. You ain't paying no bills, buying no bags, buying no heels. Goddamn, let a bitch live. All I see is 20s, 50s, 100s. If it ain't quarter meal, fuck the whip. I don't want it, but to make these niggas sick to the stomach. I be getting to the money. Everybody mad. I think I'm getting too much money. Everybody mad. Same old nigga from the block. Same old nigga with the pot. The same old nigga from the trap. Everybody hated on him, then he bounced right back. She was second stingy, now she wanna give it up. Fast life, OT, I'ma live it up. Now my ex-girl tryna make me jealous, cause she got a new nigga. She don't know that I don't give a fuck. I got me a deal, but I'm still in the street. Heard a couple niggas talking like they got beat. They forgot sesame, teriyaki sauce with the rice on the side, sweaty pussy nigga sweet. I got all this money on my motherfucking mind. Diamonds in my dial, I can't even see the time. All my niggas pull up, please don't let me bang the line. And they super extra when them niggas off the line. All I know is Bloods, Crips, Power Rules. I'm a West Side nigga, don't get it fucked up. Niggas sick, cause they thought I locked up. I be getting to the money. Everybody mad. I think I'm getting too much money. Everybody mad. Same old nigga from the block. Same old nigga with the pot. The same old nigga from the trap. Everybody hated on him, then he bounced right back. I be getting to the money. Everybody mad. I think I'm getting too much money. Everybody mad. The same old nigga from the block. The same old nigga with the pot. The same old nigga.
Child. Wait a minute, let me see. I had to get my mic today because I'm hoarse. But anyway, girl, I am hoarse from dragging a bitch and her motherfucking mama. And I don't take a motherfucking thing back. Y'all got that? Fuck that bitch and her mama. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. I said good morning. It's Monday Madness. I see everybody mad. Everybody mad. But before I get into my receipts, yeah, I'm making my coffee right now, y'all. I can't even lie. This morning, yo, this shit right here kind of hurt my feelings. And I'm going to tell you why. But yeah, this one right here, it kind of hurt my feelings. Y'all know me, y'all know I got feelings, right? Y'all know that. This one this morning, it hurt my feelings. Oh, let me get my coffee. So yeah, I woke up this morning and got my little heart broke. And I wasn't gonna go live today, but I couldn't help it. And I'm gonna tell you why. Because let me see. So yeah, I woke up this morning and I saw that there was someone live on me. And see, I just talked to this man. I just talked to this man, the day before yesterday on the phone. let me just hold on. Let me see. I can't really speak to everybody that's in the chat. Y'all see that my voice is a little gone, a lot gone. But I woke and I wasn't gonna go live today at all because clearly I'm hoarse. But when I woke up and saw that this man was live on me, somebody who I just talked to, somebody who throughout all of the things that's been going on YouTube, I talked to. When I met ZX, I'm just going to use his name since, when I met him, I didn't know anything about him. I didn't know anything about him. And, you know, he was telling me some things. I didn't even understand the sector or whatever. And I looked at him as an elder. Like a cool uncle, right? All right, I got my coffee. Hold on. So, hold on, it might work now. Hold on, let me see. I'm gonna drink it, dog. So I looked at him like he was just like an OG uncle, something like that, right? So he told me, during that time, I think I was dealing with stuff like, you know, I can't remember how we met ZX with the Treacy shit. And he was telling us about MU. And before I met him, I heard him. He kept dragging MU. And I'm like, why does this man keep dragging this woman? I'm thinking, I didn't really understand the whole MU thing, right? So when I actually, this is when he was like telling her that she needed to go to rehab. Like, are they serious about this? Like, I didn't get it. I was just watching, right? So I thought he was like trolling us. And I'm like, leave this lady alone, right? So I met him with that Treacy MU situation where Envy was going over there. Right. And I'm not like, listen, this shit hurt my feelings, but I ain't no victim. I'm not trying to play no victim role or none of that. My voice is hoarse. I'ma be straight. This shit just like really made me feel some type of way. So I would see that everywhere I went, like in different sectors, people would like troll me, like, oh, you fucking with ZX? Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out of here. Or, oh, you fuck with ZX? And I'm like, what's wrong with ZX? They would make fun of him. Let me tell you, since I met him, ZX, I've never said a word bad about him ever. No matter what anybody said. I would stand in front of his enemies. And when they asked me, do you fuck with ZX? I would still say yes. Because I did. He had did nothing to me. Do you know how embarrassing it is as a black woman to hear the things that come out of this nigga's mouth? We all supported him. Why? Because it was something different. It was something new. You know, it was grown folks, TV, it was something new. He became a morning thing for my people, some of us. And then some of us started to get turned off. As you can see, you ain't seen me in a nigga check in a very long time. But guess what? Despite some of the despicable things that came out of his motherfucking mouth, I never said a word to anybody. Not my supporters, not anybody. No, I'm horse ranching. I never said anything about him, ever. When he dragged women and called them bitches, hoes, and hookers, it turned me off. But I assumed that those women, just like he said, was attacking him first. I assumed that those women were coming for him, his daughter, his children, and his family. When he doxed people, I said, hey, they must have doxed him first, because that's what he said. But when I woke up this motherfucking morning and heard this grown ass salt and pepper motherfucker running his motherfucking mouth and speaking, calling me bitches and saying he was spitting in my motherfucking face. You will beat my ass and spit in my motherfucking face. That's what you said, right? That's what you said, right? I've never, since I met this motherfucker, said one word about this bitch. You just called me 2 days ago and said, congratulations. I'm proud of what you're doing. I'm proud of what you're doing. I see what you're doing. You're doing a great job. Stay on their necks. That's what you said. That's what you said. But guess what else you said? Guess why we had this conversation, though? Because you were about to go live on VS. You were about to go live on VS. Your title was VS is no better than Chanel. That was the title. I called you. I called this nigga. I said, please, you don't know what's going on. Chanel just dragged this lady's traumas. Like, please, don't, like, leave her alone. Please. That's what I asked him. What 88 Chanel just did to her was wrong. She didn't do anything to them. That's what I said. He said, well, VS drags children too. VS. I said, look, just I'm asking you, can you just please stay out of it? My issue is with Chanel, not VS. VS didn't do anything to her. And guess what he said? Okay, Mink, I got you, Mink. But VS. He went live. He took his live down. And he changed his live to Fire Babe is no better than VS or something like that. He changed the title. Right? He changed the title with a live. And then he came over here. Right? He came over here knowing that I said, you know, I just don't appreciate what they did to VS. So could you, he said, I understand what you're saying. You're saying to just kind of lay off of VS because they did this. I understand what you're saying, Mink. I got you, Mink. No problem, Mink. No problem, Mink. That's what he said. That's why he didn't go live on VS. So then, after I tell this bitch, nigga, he still comes over here and totally disrespects the live. Let's just be clear. He got his raggedy ass up here trying to, let me show you a receipt, man. Let me show you a receipt, man. Bitch, nigga, you just told me this on the phone. You told me about the fucking receipt on the phone. But what you wanted to do in typical ZX fashion is get your raggedy ass up over here and fuck with the person who and show your ass. Right? But bitch, nigga, what you really did was, and what I really let slide, motherfucker, is that the moment Blessed Hailey got on that panel, you called her a bitch for no reason. But see, you've been doing things to my subscribers. See, I have lesbian subscribers, some real loyal lesbian subscribers. And see, when you didn't think I was watching, I watched you disrespect them, make fun of them being lesbian, right? You remember Charnell came up there and you said, oh, Charnell had canceled a membership. Why? You were disrespecting them. You thought I didn't know? Okay. Well, that's why we haven't been in your chat. You were already disrespecting. Shout out to Charnell. Shout out to Bless Hailey. They were highly disgusted by some of the things that you were saying about lesbians. So that's really why we haven't been over there. They didn't like the things that you said. My subscribers that you said were, they wasn't shit. What you're upset is that you saw that we had been up off of you. You had about one or two of us over there that might say hello. But the things you were saying about black women, as a black woman, it's kind of hard to listen to a man go so far, right, ZX? Because you just said that me and my people were disgusting, but we've actually been disgusted by you for quite some time. But guess what I did? As a woman and as a boss, I never had to get on the internet and disrespect you. I never had to go make a live on your raggedy ass. I never made fun of you when people made fun of me for just being in your chat. I stood 10 toes down solid in the face of your enemies and still said, what? You fuck with ZX? Yeah, I have no problem with ZX. In the face of your enemies. Not my enemies, but in the face of your enemies. You weak ass bitch, nigga. So let me tell your old ass something that you can learn from a real woman like me. You said I was seeking attention because I did what? You mean I shared a post? I mean, you mean I tagged someone? So what were you doing when, I mean, everybody I came in contact with, I go to Buddy Lee's, here you come. I go to Lady Snoop, here you come. I go to Lady La, here you come. Every time I will go and maneuver and just speak to people, here you come. Throwing salt on these people. You told me that Buddy Lee was using me. You told me that Lady La was going to go at me, go at 88. You told us all those things. You put those things in our head. But the good thing is, I don't need your motherfucking advice, bitch, nigga. I don't need no advice from a motherfucker that can't even keep a hold of his motherfucking channels. You can't even follow the rules, nigga. You lost how many channels? You think I need your advice? But I pay close attention to everything you did. The way you tried to block everything. I go to Buddy Lee, like, Meek Mob, drop down. Why are you here? Meek Mob, I'm telling you, these people mean you no good. Meek Mob, then you go live. Meek Mob, Buddy Lee is using you. Buddy Lee. Buddy Lee ain't worried about your raggedy ass, nigga. It's weird. I know, King. You warned me about Lady La. I've had two encounters with Lady La. And let me tell you about Lady La. Snap it. King, go somewhere, King. I'm talking about this bitch nigga right quick. I had two encounters with Lady La. One, Queen 88 is going off. What's up, Just Kimmy? How you doing? Thank you. Thank you for the warning, baby. I might not have said anything, but trust me, I pay attention to everything. Trust me. I'm no dummy. Because when the motherfucker got to throw salt and go, Meg,
they're coming after you, Meg. Meg.
Shit. Every time we talk, we over here chilling and shit. Here you come. Here comes ZX. Then what he do? Go live. Like a little bitch. You said I was a bitch? You called me a what? Okay, well, let's go, ZX. So,
Meg, I'm telling you, don't, Buddy Lee is not gonna get you, I swear. And Kimmy did this to me, and my baby. Meg, don't go over there, Meg, I'm telling you, Meg.
Queen, move 3 Sector, hello, ZX over here. Don't go. Don't go to Buddy Lee.
Don't go to Buddy Lee. Why y'all ain't Buddy Lee? Leave Buddy Lee alone. Don't mess with Buddy Lee. Don't mess with Lady Lott. Don't mess with Lady Lott. Mama, no. Mink, don't do it, Mink.
Not on my watch. Block them. Block them. Block Bond Dog. Block them. They mess with me. Block them. Block them. Block them. They can't come over here. What is it? Nigga. You don't control the motherfucking thing over here. The fuck? Like, you don't get your
cooling. Y'all like cooling now. Y'all like rim shaking now. Y'all like good people, but y'all don't come over here no more.
Shut the fuck up, nigga. Shut the fuck up. I'ma talk to you, horse. Like, for real. I never said nothing bad about this movie, y'all. That shit is crazy. King, you're gonna shut up. Hold on.
Buddy Lee! Buddy Lee!
Damn. Hold on. Look, this coffee working a little bit.
VS is mean. Don't mess with her.
I'm like, damn, so everybody? So like everybody's bad? Like, damn, nigga. And I hate to do this. This is why you need to mind your motherfucking business, nigga. Damn, just mind your business. Don't get it nothing right. Hold on.
You know Lady Snoop ain't shit. Lady Snoop is.
Hold on. I had to go upstairs because King is running amok. So, can y'all still hear me? Okay. So, this nigga, like, you know, And it's nothing wrong with wanting somebody, of somebody. But the way he would do it would be like, we over there chilling, and it's like, he would just like, make it so, it would be like weird and uncomfortable, because I'm not even over there like that. Like, we might go hit the link. He's like, no, don't do it on their panel. Do it on your panel. Don't do it there. Do it on your panel. Do it on your panel. I'm like, bro, like, I'm like, and I give respect to him, like, you know, so I'm like, okay, like, ZX, I got it. I'm not dumb. Like, I got it. I, you know, no problem. Right. So the other day when he called me and was like, I understand what you're doing. I respect what you're doing and all that. This is funny. So when I said, so right now, he went live and said that the way that I spoke about Chanel's raggedy ass mama was disrespectful, right? Now, I'm looking at some titles of his videos. I recall him saying that he would fuck a skull of someone's deceased mother. I recall several disrespectful things he said to people's mother. He has naked pictures of people's mother. Like, excuse me? I recall when Five Babe said something about his daughter. He doxed her whole family, children and all. Right? So he claims that I am just as bad as Chanel. Now, I want to tell all of you people that are listening, I don't give a fuck about Chanel. Because this ZX was nowhere to be found when it was 10 police at my motherfucking door because of this bitch. ZX was nowhere to be found when I had to take CPS calls made by this bitch. ZX was nowhere to be found where the bitches that's on this panel right now was making up stories about my son being molested. ZX was nowhere to be found when they were calling my family. ZX was nowhere to be found when they was talking about my 8-year-old son sucking dick. ZX was nowhere to be found when they were calling my child school. ZX, fuck you. And anybody who has a problem with me speaking to her mother that way, you can go fuck yourself. I don't give a fuck what you think. If you don't have a motherfucking child, I don't give a fuck what you think. Because one thing I've said on this motherfucking app is when it comes to my motherfucking baby, my child, I don't have any CPS cases. I take good care of mine. I don't give a fuck what you think about how I respond about my motherfucking child. And I don't know where the fuck ZX was when that bitch was tormenting my mom, Who Kim, and her baby, and doxing all of my subscribers. I don't know where that bitch nigga was. I don't know where none of you scared motherfuckers was at. Because I told you motherfuckers, you could stay out the way. Stay out of it. Because you don't know what's going on. You wasn't there on Christmas when the police went to my mother's house to go retrieve my motherfucking child. So don't tell me about disrespecting nobody's mother. Because I don't get on this motherfucking cry and complain and moan about what the fuck somebody did to me. But that bitch knows what she's done. So what I'm telling you motherfuckers is to mind your motherfucking business. Because you wasn't there when you didn't get those phone calls from that older, one of my senior subscribers telling me that Chanel was threatening her life and she ended up in the motherfucking hospital with a stroke because she was so scared. You wasn't there when Chanel went to Florida and came back and said one of our good friend's husband raped her. Which was a lie. You motherfuckers ain't read these motherfucking stories in this motherfucking narrative of what the fuck this bitch did to her own motherfucking kids. Y'all wasn't there when this bitch told me, cried day after night, and night after night, that somebody was saying that she killed her daughter. She really did do that shit. So I don't want to hear you motherfuckers coming at me about what the fuck I gotta say. Because you were too scared to open your motherfucking mouth. My baby was getting dragged. I didn't ask for no motherfucking help. I said, stay out the fucking way. I don't give a fuck what you're talking about. ZX, did you tell the people? So we told y'all that the picture of Treacy's mama in the casket, since we talking about disrespecting mamas, bitch, nigga. Where did it come from? You sent that casket picture to Chanel. Did you forget, bitch? You over there talking about Chanel. Somebody disrespect your mama, but you sent a picture. It's okay when they be, it was okay when it was Treacy. In the middle of the night, when I was asleep, you sent a picture to Chanel of Treacy's dead mother in a casket, which is still up today, right? But you're talking about mamas. Didn't you say, didn't you call, what's his name? What's that? Wasn't you calling somebody's mama? Huh? But see, this is why I'm going to tell you bitch niggas to mind your motherfucking business. Because you sent that. You said, you told Chanel, well, I was asleep. I told Chanel to ignore Tracy. You said, no, this is the way to shut her up. And you gave her the casket with her dead mama. You did that. Because you didn't want to do it yourself, bitch nigga. You gave it to Chanel. You said what? We were who was trash? Oh, okay. Hold on. Let me also tell you, since you motherfuckers want to speak on me and what the fuck I got to say to this bitch mama. Here comes the airdrop. I didn't hear nobody saying anything when she said my son was getting fucked in the ass. I didn't hear anybody asking me when CPS came and asking they wanted to ask my son about being molested. I didn't hear none of you motherfuckers saying a word, but that y'all didn't want to hear it. So why the fuck is this so important now? Because this ain't about Chanel. This is about VS. Where the fuck was you at when Skokohannes was making up stories about my son being molested that never happened? Where were you motherfuckers when these deadbeat bitches was running around talking about children sucking dick? Where was y'all at? Scared? Oh, okay. So you want... Oh, okay. That's it. Where was y'all at? Sleep? Oh, okay. Wait, y'all woke now? What, y'all woke? Like, how y'all wake so fast? You wake so fast? You woke? How y'all wake up so fast? Because it's me. Why my name get titled so quick? You ain't asked, was I good? Was I okay? You ain't asked me that. You didn't care when the police was coming at my door. They were trying to get me to lose my job for no fucking reason. Y'all wasn't there. You again, I'm going to repeat. You wasn't there the day after Christmas when my son is spending his holiday with my mother, my grandmother, and my family. And the sheriff's knocking at my mother's door for my son, my 8-year-old son. You wasn't there? Oh, okay. So you gonna tell me how to fight back? You gonna tell me when I had enough? You gonna tell me what the fuck to say out of my mouth? You gonna tell me who to call, who not to call? Oh, okay. So she could call my mother, right? They could call my mother, disrespect my mother, put my people on her. Oh, okay. Oh, okay. So they can disrespect our deceased children. But you said I dragged somebody's kid? No, I said rest in peace to her baby. Because her mother killed her. And that's on period. Did you read the receipts? Did you read the articles? Did you read the charges? No? Oh, okay. Gotcha. So for those of you who are so appalled about me calling this bitch a bitch, let me explain to you why I have no respect for her mama. I'm about to show you some correspondence between me and Carol's mother. So, for those of you who don't know, Carol is not supposed to be around her children at all. She's not supposed to be around them. Okay? So, when she made this video, I'm just going to show y'all some of the correspondence with me and her mother. And you tell me if you give this bitch some respect. I'm going to show you some of them now. And I'll show you the rest later because I don't really have enough time. I mean, I just don't have. I'll show y'all what else her mother did that I don't give a fuck. Fuck her. It's coming through. Now, first off, on Bizarre's platform, y'all heard me disrespect Chanel's mother, right? And I want you all to, this is who, he said, oh, this is so wrong, I'm trash. This was yesterday. This is yesterday at 5 o'clock in the morning.
Girlfriend. She Cooper or the vintage BMW, man. Let's see what this is right here. Oh, okay. So let's leave this right here. She stated, let me show this receipt. Last. Now, let's start right here. Hold on. Let me get my receipts in order. Okay, let's start with Faye Cheryl. Faye Cheryl Lewis is Delonda's mother, girlfriend. She's 76 years old. Faye is 76 years old. This is Delonda's mother's girlfriend. Absolutely. So, you see this, you remember some time ago, you said that your mother sold a house for $400,000+. But see, what you fail to realize is your mother go with a motherfucking 80-year-old woman who really got the bag, bitch. And your motherfucking mother is using this lady. Don't worry, I already contacted the family members. That's going to be on part two, and it's recorded. Don't worry. Thank me later, whore. thank me later. Really got the bag, bitch.
Lady Snoop, could you come? Could you come? Lady Snoop, where are you again? Where y'all at? Y'all said what? Don't do what? This is 5 o'clock in the morning.
And your motherfucker realizes your mother go with a motherfucking 80-year-old woman who really got the bag, bitch. And your motherfucking mother is using this lady. Don't worry, I already contacted the family members. That's going to be on part two, and it's recorded. Don't worry. Thank me like really got the bag, bitch. And your motherfucking mother is using this lady. Don't worry, I already contacted the family members. That's gonna be on part two, and it's recorded. Don't worry. Thank me later, whore. They sold the house for $400,000+. But see, what you fail to realize is your mother go with a motherfucking 80-year-old woman who really got the bag, bitch. And your motherfucking mother is using this lady. Don't worry, I already contacted the family members. That's gonna be on part two in this recording. Don't worry.
ZX, you minding my business? You minding my business? She's sitting here talking about my mother and my grandmother at 5 o'clock in the morning, talking about she's contacting my family. Do you think I give a fuck about her mother? Am I supposed to give a fuck about her mother, bitch nigga? Are you minding my business? What? Where y'all ain't going? My mother, they could just call my mother, send the police to my mother's house, do all of this shit, right? Y'all must think I'm a bitch. Oh, okay. Okay. This is when you don't mind the fucking business that pays you. See this? This is... See this? This is LaJean reaching out to me. See that? See that? You see, LaJean, but I'm letting her know that the child that Carol is not even supposed to have is she has online telling us to suck his dick. Mind you, his father has contacted me asking why the fuck does she is asking me if his son is around Carol. Why? Excuse me? Oh, okay. Carol said, and there's cussing on there? She's appalled. She knows exactly who her fucking daughter is. And I said, I sent you the whole video. She comes on at 2:30 minutes. She puts Philip on there saying, you can suck my son's dick. See, y'all need to mind your motherfucking business. Because her mother was on that motherfucker lying. She's also lied on me several times. But see, her mother wants to contact me, right? Because she can't, okay? Not only that, she says that I'm sending her, excuse me, but my family is on your daughter's wall. That's my aunt. That's my mother. That's my aunt. I'm telling her what the fuck she's doing. This needs to stop. Did she? Oh, she said she was being stalked. Huh? Hello? Did she say she was being stalked? Oh, okay. Thank you for the new membership, y'all. Thank you. See, I was contacting her mother. I said, my family is on the page, and I still haven't posted any pictures of you. So have that conversation with your daughter. She gets no passes from me. I've never called CPS on her. She said unpleasant things are going on. So, however, she's called the police and CPS. I take care of my child. She's calling my child's school. I spoke the truth. And I spoke the truth for the things she's done. She said, okay. I said, the way she's threatening Chase, the way she treats Chase, yes, I spoke on it. The way she treats Princess, yes, I spoke on it. Her mother is very aware of how she does her fucking children. So if you guys think I'm going to respect a motherfucker like that, you got me fucked up. Her mother knows exactly what she's done to her children, and she's covered up her crimes for a very long time. So you think I give a fuck about this lady? I don't. Because without reaching out to her, I asked her, please, have a talk to her. Talk to her. I'm not disrespecting you. Like, this is not cool. I stood up for her and her deceased child when nobody else would, but it was a lie. And it's funny that she got up here and told y'all that it was a lie. She would never tell me that it was a lie. So I don't give a fuck what y'all talking about. Mind your fucking business. Because y'all don't give a fuck about the things that I know, the receipts that I've shown. Y'all don't give a fuck about it. So why the fuck you give a fuck about how I react? Fuck you. And everything you stand for. Skoka, you can kiss my ass. I will never take a motherfucking thing down until you get on this motherfucker and say you lied about my child. You said my son sucked dick. You said he molested my next door neighbor. You got on there, made a 3-hour live. Bitch. Get your raggedy ass up here and say you lied, or fuck you. You lied on my son for no reason. I don't give a fuck what y'all think about your own kids. Because when it come to mine, you're not going to do that to me. You're not going to disrespect my people's children either. Because we're good fucking mothers over here. If you don't give a fuck about your kids and you get CPS cases and let your kids be taken away, that's not me. And I'd be damned if you bitches that don't give a fuck about your own kids get on here and play a victim. All the dirty shit y'all did. You want to put it on me? Say it to my face. And for you motherfuckers saying I ran with Chanel, say it to my face and show me proof. And read them fucking charges. If you ain't gonna read that shit, fuck you. I don't give a fuck about your opinion. I don't need none of you motherfuckers. I stand on my own. The fuck? Oh yeah. She said, I'm not her. My page doesn't have anything to do with you. My days are always blessed. This is a scary ass mama. I said, ma'am, you need to have a conversation with your daughter. I'm sure you know exactly what she does on the internet. I haven't posted any pictures of you or your page. Carol posted pictures of you. Air your grievances out with your child. Someone's dead mother in a casket. That's Carol. That's Tracy's mother. So everybody's mother can be disrespected, but this bitch's? Y'all want to go? So y'all want to have a kumbaya for this bitch's mama? She said she's being stalked. Oh, okay. In messages. I don't like being spoken on. No one knows me, period. But it won't take me out of my square. I'm secure in who I am. Again, find your peace or keep going back and forth with ridiculous drama. I said, as I told you before, I wasn't disrespectful to you, to your grandchildren, but if I be damned if she put my son in danger like she does and has done to her own damn kids, trust me, it won't be drama, but I absolutely don't play about my child. I take care of mine, unlike Carol. Excuse me. So don't tell me that I was harassing someone's mother, because several times she's reached out to me first about Carol. Mind your fucking business. I'm gonna drop the link because my voice is kind of, I have so much to like, it's like I stay out of y'all shit when y'all get in this stuff with these people, but y'all want to get in my motherfucking business. I'm dropping the link. I don't give a fuck about a mama. Thank you, Maisha, for the cash app. If she doesn't want to be involved, why did she get on the live yesterday and even twerked when they asked her to? Exactly. I dropped the link. So let me go hear what this nigga had to say. Let's see if it makes sense.
I mean, thanks to that whole.
What do you think? You got Meek Mob naked injections and, oh, okay, all that's funny. What's going on? Grown folks TV. How you doing, fam? Love. 91 technology. Hurt me the most was that want to justify the disrespect to that woman's mother. Her mother was not ghetto. Her mother came up on that panel. She passed her mother the phone. And that lady said very, very politely, please stop calling me. Please stop calling my phone. My daughter is a grown woman. Whatever you got with her, you deal with her. I don't understand. What the fuck is wrong with you? When you disrespect somebody's mother in front of 1,200, 1,300 people, you reveal who the fuck you are, as far as I'm concerned.
Fuck you.
Hey. Hello, salute.
Hi, Mink.
Hi, baby.
Hold on, I watch. I can't hear.
On my watch.
Hold on, y'all. Don't say nothing. I can't hear.
Before you say anything, ZX, you little glitter boots. You disrespected me. You disrespected Mink. You disrespected our squad, and you disrespected Not On My Watch. You weak old man. Like,
y'all saying something.
You wanted to play sat up there and you let another grown man on your panel disrespect me as a woman, but you're talking about other people being disrespected. Like,
can you hear?
I can hear.
I don't think
you can hear us.
Trying to play something.
Y'all can hear?
And I'm sorry about that, baby. Both
had his microphone hooked up and now I can't.
Is it okay? Could you hear me?
I wonder why I can't hear you.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder what happened. Is somebody saying something?
Yeah. No, I was. but yeah, he allowed another man to disrespect me. You threw me behind stage. twice when I was answering a question that you asked. You just real disrespectful, my nigga. Like all jokes aside, you a lot of things that I can't say on Meek Monetized channel, but
this video ain't monetized.
Oh, it's not monetized. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
But still, I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna get that dark. But you talking about Meek disrespecting somebody's mother when you gave that animal the picture of Treacy's mother that is still on her thumbnail, and you still have that video on your community wall from 5 months ago. And then you're gonna title your live, Mink is no better than Chanel, but you let that monster who tangled her baby in a blind on your panel, sir. You ain't shit. And your mama ain't shit. She raised an ain't shit nigga.
Okay, let you want to go bless Holly, because I got a lot to say.
Let me clear my throat. Nigga, fuck you and your motherfucking mama. Any and everybody on these YouTube streets know bless Holly stay in her own lane, and I don't fuck with nobody. But nigga, you hit this motherfucking panel and call me a motherfucking bitch.
Is that me?
I ain't never disrespected your gay, rainbow, bright looking ass. So, fuck you. And your mama, the bitch should have swallowed
Jamie.
You instead of giving yes, birth baby. To you, nigga. And I said what the fuck I said. That bitch should have swallowed you because you a piece of shit ass nigga. I ain't never hit your chat because I don't like the way you disrespect women, my nigga. Fuck you, you bald headed gay bitch. Now, I said what the fuck I said.
He got all this energy. He got all this energy for women and gay men. And women and gay men. Where's the straight men energy? Why you're not going back and forth with the straight men? Why are you talking to gay men?
He wanna be with a nigga. He in a motherfucking closet.
He talked so bad about Rick Reed. He made me go find Rick Reed. And guess what? I like Rick Reed better than I like you, ZX. That says a lot about you, bitch nigga.
So, okay.
Go ahead.
Hold on. I'm gonna just ask you this. Like, outside of the insults and shit like that, we have been having some issues, conversations about, you know, ZX in the, recently. Not recently, but months ago. Do you mind, like, because I wasn't really there for what happened, but yeah, we were all talking about it, and I really didn't know. Like, we were really, like, as a whole, we were all kind of torn as far as our support for ZX. And
because I did not, like, every time I went to his chat, he was always talking about gay, lesbian. He was always that's what he was always talking about. So I felt very uncomfortable. I didn't like it. Not only that, I did not like the way he talked about women. I'm from the old school. I don't get down like that. So I didn't like it. So, of course, we was trying to have this conversation, and you was like, well, he ain't did nothing. Okay, I get it. Y'all can go over there, but I'm not. So, I mean, we did not want to be associated with him. At all.
So
I never went to his check. But, of course, they kept sharing it. They kept sharing these, you know, because what we do is we have people pages in our Discord. We really do. They're sharing space. I just not hit it. I just didn't go over there. But you held it down. You was like, well, bless Harley. Nah. I was like, okay, but I'm not going over there.
But we wasn't over there.
No, none of us was over there.
Like, but I still didn't, like, just outright disrespect them, no matter. And my people was coming to me saying that they was feeling disrespected, and I'm like, so about the other day, bless Holly, when you called into the panel, what was you calling in to tell him, and what did he do?
I called in to say something to you. I called in to say, D, why you letting him up here disrespect women? And before I could even get anything out, the man started calling me out, calling bitches. I ain't never said two words to him. I ain't never typed in his chat. I've never did none of that. And the first thing he said to me, have a motherfucking mother, a grandmother. Okay? The first thing that man said to me was, you bitch, and da-da-da-da. That's what he said.
Yeah, so he...
That's what he said. So, I didn't say shit to
him. He said that he came over here and felt disrespected. Let me tell you one thing, ZX. The moment that you said, when you called Bless Holly a bitch, I didn't give a fuck about what nobody said. I actually tried my best to hold it in. But the things you were saying to Lady Snoop was so disgusting. So when she let you have it, what was I to say? I stayed out of it because you asked for it. You got up here. For no reason, to just do the most. That's what you did. You got up here to be disrespectful. You got up here hate. You got up here to be disrespectful. You got up here to be hating. Not only that, when Blessed Highly hit the link, bitch, nigga. You called her bitch, and I didn't even check you. I didn't say anything. My Discord was in an uproar. And I just dropped Bless Holly down because I didn't want to get into it with ZX on the panel and give him the satisfaction that day. I let it go. If you don't believe me, we can go right to it. Matter of fact, I will. Carry on, ladies.
Okay. Now, one thing I want to say is ZX always says he takes pride in loyalty. Loyalty, and respect. And we have done nothing but been loyal to him and his platform, respected him and his platform. Nobody has ever, from this camp, from Watch Tribe or anything, have ever disrespected him in any way and ever been disloyal to him in any way. And him not knowing what she has done with your mother, your grandmother, your kid, not knowing any history or anything, for him to do a live on you and say the things he said. And also, I'm not just talking about Meek. I'm talking about me. I'm talking about the whole entire squad and not knowing what's going on. It's past beyond disappointed. I'm not even disappointed. I'm fucking pissed. Because the fact that you would say all the stuff that you would say about, you know, being respectful, and he's never seen, you know, so many disrespectful people and everything, speaking of other people, and then to have on your platform the main person that drags children and drags the dead and sits up there talk about sexual stuff with an 8-year-old and a 9-year-old, and that is the person that you have on your panel, and the nerve to sit up there and say Meek is no different from Chanel, and not even knowing the charges and everything of what she's done. She doesn't even respect her own mother.
He ain't no motherfucker. He has no idea
of the charges that this girl does and has. Girl. And we have never, never, ever once disrespected you, ZX, disrespected your platform, or anything. And that is some real fucked up shit. But you know what? Life goes on. And he's going to see exactly the people that was on his panel. He's going to see exactly what they're about. And guess what? I'm not going to send no receipts. I'm going to do a fucking live. And I'm going to show all the fucking sick shit that they've said and what they've done to your mother and your grandmother and our children. And that's all I got to say right now until I go live. And I will be going live later on this.
Kim, okay, I gotta fuck go him. Fuck him. I told y'all, I knew from the jump, the way he talk about women, he can't, we thought we was gonna be any different. That
thank you,
don't even respect his mama. He ain't got no respect for no woman. What is in the closet, right. Trapped in the closet, guys. That motherfucker trapped in the closet and mad at the world. Nigga, get out the closet, put your glitter boots on, and dance around, my nigga.
Look, it's 2023. It's 2023. You ain't gotta be afraid.
For real.
You ain't gotta be afraid to be yourself.
I let him make it because I stay in my lane. That day, I let him make it because you know what? I don't want, it's too much. chaos on this board, and everybody always coming to this house. You know what? I'm gonna shut up. I'm gonna let that nigga make it. But nigga, hey, I ain't none of these females. That's why I keep my bad clothes. Cause I put them to that bitch gangsta boo. That's why this bitch gangsta boo. And it's for a motherfucking reason. I don't brag about what I got. I don't brag about what the fuck I can do. But I will fuck you up. Point blank period. Don't fuck with me at all.
Right. The most realist, the most loyalist, the most respectful women around here, and have the audacity to call us.
First of all, a lot of these people around here think that.
And we mom squad for life, period.
A lot of people think, oh, we just the squad from the chat because a lot of us don't hit panels and we don't scratch in mob squad. That's not what we do. And most of us, we don't all the time hit the panel. But what y'all not gonna keep doing is coming for the squad like we some weak ass people, cause we're not. We're very highly educated around here, and y'all fail to even know that we have doctors in the squad. We have accountants in the squad, nurses in the squad, respiratory therapists in the squad. Business owners in the squad. What the fuck y'all got over there besides some booty shakers and hoes? None of y'all over there work. None of y'all over there have a real 9 to 5.
Lori B, what you're saying?
Let me say this right quick, Rudy, to piggyback off what you just said. I heard of somebody do a live yesterday, and the person said they got all this, and they said they got all that. We don't see it, baby girl. When you a boss, you ain't got to show what you got. But you must not been looking, baby girl, because I cammed up my home. I cammed up my estate. Okay? So, yeah, whatever we say we got going on over here, you ain't got to prove what you got, baby. When you about that life, you don't talk about it. You be about it. Point blank. I don't talk about my bank account, baby. I'm about that life. Point blank, period. Y'all should try that.
They want us to cam up and twerk and be hoes like them. We're not. We're not the same. You would never be able to sit at a table with a women in mob squad because y'all are bottom of the barrel. Bitches don't got their kids. Bitches don't got their teeth. Bitches don't got refrigerators. Bitches don't got couches. What are y'all doing? What is y'all really doing over there? CPS cases running rampant over there. Pulling out guns, fighting your children. Just raggedy. Bottom of the barrel. Y'all not even bottom of the barrel. Y'all the bottom of the bottom of the bottom of the barrel.
My bad. Let's go, baby.
For real, like,
I'm trying to order my coffee and then I'm gonna speak.
Hold on. The hood rats, all are on. Listen.
That's 8 minus all her goddamn children talking. Mm. Bitch, you don't got none of them, bitch. Do girl, bye.
Listen.
Hold on, everybody. Look, I swear to God.
As they scream in front of their children, what a good job, ZX. Your first day in the hood. Look at you.
Listen to me, lady. Please. Oh, because they be screaming.
Bitch, your gang is not ganging, bitch.
Who are they talking to?
Not children-ing.
This man or nothing. I didn't even know he was going live about the situation or the topic at hand. So, for this bitch in this chat trying to tell me that I'm being messy and I'm trying to get this man to pick my side, that's a lie. I've been on him. When I met him, he told me I was like a daughter to him.
Yeah, let's go. Yes, you are. Yes, when you met her, she was like a daughter to you. There's your daughter.
Yeah, I'm like a daughter to him.
need to do. I'm not trying to manipulate this man or nothing. I didn't even know he was going live about the situation or the topic at hand. So, for this bitch in this chat trying to tell me that I'm being messy and I'm trying to get this man to pick my side, that's a lie. I didn't know him. When I met him, he told me I was like a daughter to him. So,
y'all, she ain't been in your chat ever since, dumb nigga. But he ain't, she ain't.
What y'all talking about? Said anything about
me. He ain't getting a subscriber, nah membership from the bitch. You ain't get a motherfucking thing. Hey,
she don't get memberships. The bitch is broke.
Motherfucking thing, you dirty motherfucker. I hope you have. Listen to this. Let's hear it. Exactly. Exactly. And who introduced them? Exactly. We did.
I just didn't come back over here because I didn't want to put him in a situation where he felt like he had to choose a side or whatever. So. I backed away from him. I did not know he was doing this live today. I did not know his thoughts nor his opinions. I respect them. I appreciate them. That's it. I'm not trying
to. You respect them. Oh, I respect you for saying Mink is worse than me or Mink is just like me. I respect you for saying I'm a dirty, dusty bitch. I'm a trifling. Baby, y'all fall for anything, ho. Get the fuck out of here. Why? Wait a minute. Watch did with the lie that I doxed her, yet she lied and tried to drag my kids. Right. We've already apologized to Coolin. He's upset that we apologized to Coolin. I mean, when you're wrong, you have to admit that you're wrong.
Me
and Cooler had already went through that, and we already apologized to each other and started it. So I don't know why she's trying to go.
Not
back.
On my watch. He listened to something.
He had to choose a side or whatever. So I backed away from him. I did not know he was doing this live today. I did not know his thoughts nor his opinions. I respect them. I appreciate them. I'm not trying to manipulate this man or nothing. I didn't even know he was going live about the situation or the topic at hand. So, for this bitch in this chat trying to tell me that I'm being messy and I'm trying to get this man to pick my side, that's a lie. I've been knowing him. When I met him...
Girl, I don't... This is hilarious. Let me see.
Very hilarious.
You know, what y'all women go through, that's your thing.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Women are catty.
Yeah, they catty. That's
it.
Is Cream
over there? Listen, they are all fighting now.
I'm hoping y'all can talk a little bit. I know Queen is wanting to come up also.
Oh, not Queen, baby. Oh, this is good, yes.
This man or nothing. I didn't even know he was going to come. And I'm not up here arguing and yelling while they're down in the chat calling me a hoe saying I'm trying to jump on this lady. Man. I ain't fed anything.
You told the truth. You told the truth.
They're mad because some gang don't even have each other's back. They don't even like each other. Oh, your gang is not ganging, bitch. Your gang is not ganging. You sit watching ass.
This is what happens when you jump in business that you don't know. Oh, that looks like they're having grown folks talk over there.
Right. Grown folks. Who is that?
Cream the 88 girl.
I swear to God, you, listen to me, lady. Please. You know what? Like, I don't...
Wait, hold on. Glad you're an adult and know the difference between going back to that space and speaking on it so it's clear how we got here. Right. Right.
You said that's 88 and cream.
Listen. I like
Pizarro's channel because they be screaming and hollering. I don't like fucking Snoop's channel because they be screaming and hollering. Hold on, baby.
Yeah, the same bitch that said my son was sucking dick. Bitch, you could die slow, nigga. Fuck him.
It was at this moment he knew he fucked up.
Right.
You can't take them little bitches nowhere.
Exactly.
To the left, they gut an ass in the Mo 3 sector.
They over there trying to be good. They over there trying, bitch.
Because I have seen her name and I've been over.
Like a crackhead trying to stay sober.
I just was like, come up, give me your opinion. I don't want her to be uncomfortable. Like I said, everything that I give people is what I want. So I want her to be comfortable. I want y'all to be comfortable. You dig?
Life is uncomfortable. There's no way you can help her.
He wants, at least I got you in the Mo 3 sector, ZX. I really got you popping. CB, wait till you expose 88. Wait till you expose 88. This is going to be funny. They said he was all over Nika Jenkins. ZX, this is so desperate of you. I mean, you were like my uncle, man. My feelings are really hurt, but hey, fuck you. Mm-hmm. My feelings, like, y'all, I can't even lie. Yo, my feelings hurt with this one. I'm like, damn, ZX.
Me too. Like, really?
Right, he got in because she's going to go, they're going to go right back over there with Buddy Lee and Tracy.
Mm-hmm.
They fuck with Buddy Lee, Tracy, all your ops. They'll be dragging him in no time, guys. Don't worry.
No time.
Dang.
That went fast. Congratulations.
She don't know how to scratch well, so she gonna fuck up soon.
She doesn't even know. She's trying to hold it, not call her daughter a slut and everything.
Right. She can't hold it in for too long. She gonna fuck up.
This is the most words they ever said without dragging kids on one panel. Look, Skull Mysterious is the fakest one up there, so she's like, don't disrespect the man. She's like, okay, I got this man I can fuck around with. Okay, cool. This is how they network, though.
This is hilarious.
Right, OC girl.
Well, no, this was quick.
Staff.
You hate Pizarro? Well, you sure do love these numbers that she got over there. Down to 161 now, but. Ooh. Wait a minute. Alert. Coolin said, fuck Skull Mysterious. Now it's up. Let's go, Cooler! Yo, I'm kind of mad at me. Sometimes, you know, you glad things happen the way. Like, maybe Cooler and I needed to go at war for me to appreciate Cooler. I really like Cooler. I like Cooler more now than I did.
Yeah. What'd you say, me? They went over there and turned that up real quick.
No, I'm saying that who are they arguing with? It's 88 arguing with Green. I like Coolin now more than I did when like we first met her, and then through the beef and then all of that, like I like her more now. Y'all understand what I'm saying? Y'all get what I'm saying? I used to be like, motherfucker, motherfucker, motherfucker. But like now it's like, I know I'm saying, like, I'm not saying I didn't like you before. I'm saying like, now I like you more than that. Shut the fuck up, Cool.
This is hilarious. You got hood rats on your panel. Can't respect your panel.
And you said I was just like these bitches.
He don't know what is going on his panel. He can't control
nothing.
That's
what he gets.
Wait, hold on. Hold on, wait, hold on. Pisces vibe. Oh my God. She said, I love me some cooler. She's a female for the D-Williams.
She's smooth. Not Billy D. Williams.
No, it really is. She really is a female Billy D. Williams. She's smooth. Oh my God. Y'all got me crazy. Oh my God. Oh,
this is worth everything that happened, honey. I don't even give a damn.
Girl.
Are you still listening or can I speak yet?
Oh, yeah. Go ahead.
Okay, uh-oh. So this one really hurt my. Go ahead.
Go ahead. This is Mrs. ZX herself, honey. He said he got you. This is Mrs. ZX. He put her in his intro.
Yeah. Let's go. I mean,
he was going to put all my people in the intro. I said, I'm not sending no fucking picture. I'm my own person.
Right. So what I want to say is this. This one really hurt me this morning because I championed for him when things were going wrong within the squad and they didn't want to go over there. I was like, no, well, you know, he has his opinion. And I was very conflicted because I have people who I consider my sisters who he has disrespected. And so I was conflicted with that. And I kept explaining. So slowly but surely, I have backed off. I did have a membership, and I did what was a lot on his platform. The last couple of weeks, I definitely haven't been there as much as I was in the past. But the stuff he did this morning, it hurt my feelings. And for him to talk to Meek the way he did and say he was spitting her face was so disrespectful. He wants people to honor his daughter and respect his daughter, but you can disrespect someone else's daughter, mother, aunt, uncles, whoever. Is very hypocritical to me. And it's a bunch of bullshit. Because, nigga, you ain't standing on shit in my book. Nothing. If somebody talked to your daughter the way you talked to me, you had to come see about it, right? So, just like you got a daughter, Meek is somebody's daughter. My father. And it is... My soul is on fire right now because I cannot believe how disrespectful he was. He said he had spit in your face. Nigga, you spit in somebody's face and we'll pull them fucking dishes out your mouth and whoop your old ass. How about that? I'm just appalled. I cannot believe the shit that he said out of his mouth with his hypocritical ass. You done called people's mothers on the phone. You said you would have sex with somebody's mother just last week. You said it. You got somebody's neck on your damn community post if you didn't take it down already, because it was there. I saw it. But you're a fucking hypocrite. And the children dragging thing, I get it, because I don't like it. And for you to say that Mom Squad does that, you a lie. You are a liar. I'll call you that out of my mouth. You're a liar. You ain't never seen me nowhere dragging nobody's child, ever. I don't drag children. I'm a mother and a grandmother. I don't drag children, bitch nigga. So for you to say that out your mouth, that was disrespectful. Now you got these hood rat bitches sitting up on your platform, tearing your shit up. Meek is just as bad as them. You haven't heard the filthy ass stuff they have said about this girl's child and others' children and people's mothers who have passed on. So I can't. I have no respect for him at all. Like for real, none. And I was riding hard for CX. You know I was riding hard for him. The squad can tell you how hard I wrote for him. We was loyal as hell to him. I wouldn't even drop down in people's chats that didn't dislike him. Because he would say somebody he liked, I go over there, join, they, you know, severe sub, he fall out with him. I'm like, well, damn. Every time I join somebody, every time I turn around, he done dipped out on him. Intrinsic. He did it to Intrinsic. He just did it to Reed recently. I'm like, well, I don't know what's going on. So I had a conversation with him, and we talked about it. So I don't have a problem with you dropping down in people's chats, blah, 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 blah. So that's just how loyal I was to him. And so for him to respond that way, because somebody cuts to somebody's mother. But I want you to know this, DX. Mick got the phone number to Carol's mother from Carol. And she got the number when Carol needed her to call her mother, have conversations with her mother, because she was over there getting her ass whipped with her child in the house, nigga. Since you want to know, you talk. It ain't like she looked the number up. The bitch gave her the number. Gave it to her. Her mother had conversations and text messages.
When that nigga was spitting in her face.
Exactly. Her mother was so concerned that she said, oh, I'll go when I get finished doing what I'm doing. So you upholding the wrong bitch. That's what you're doing. The wrong bitch. Because her mother had disabled her and her sick-ass behavior all this time. Her mother knew exactly what she was doing. So we're supposed to respect her mother when she allows her child. My children would never disrespect somebody's mother the way that girl did. Ever. And they grown. I wish the fuck they would. My children would never. That comes from home training. Home training. That girl has none. Because somebody disrespect her mother. And at 5 o'clock in the morning, she up disrespecting somebody's mother and grandmother. It's supposed to give her mother respect. Fuck her mother. And fuck you.
Exactly. How do you address the others? Yeah, this was all. This wasn't even about that. This was about ZX because, I mean, VS, because he said that I disrespected him on my panel. I didn't show him no respect. But I'm going to show y'all. What was the name of that live, y'all? Was that the first day or the second day?
It was the day it was the Toya's name, Latoya. Latoya. It was deadbeat bitches or something like that. My soul is on fire right now. I can't stand a fucking hypocrite. And you want to try to justify the shit you do and say out your mouth based on the Bible. Based on the Bible. Man, get the fuck out of here. So you tell me, the Bible also says you're supposed to respect your elders. So Vic DeMone's mama, that ain't your elder. Lady Law's mama and other people wasn't your elders, nigga. Well, you try to do that Bible fucking bullshit that you stand on that don't mean nothing because you ain't standing by it yourself with the selective outrage you got.
Are y'all sure that it's that live?
Yes, that's the one with first one she ever came over there.
But it wasn't the first day she came over there. I think it was the second. It had to be the second day. Because the first
one with the deadbeat bitches on there. That's the one it was. That he jumped up on the panel. Because that's when VS got up on the panel. He came there and wanted to show us the receipt.
Right.
A 3-year-old receipt. As if a person that can't have redemption. People can change. And if she don't change, I mean, people push you to a point. They push you to a fucking point. They harass you and keep doing stuff to you. They push you to a point. But you feel justified to say the things you say because you get pushed to a point that disrespect you? Well, what makes you any better than anybody else? Because of you? That's some bullshit. I held my tongue and held my tongue and just kept going. I fought with the girls in the group to keep supporting him. That's crazy.
I'm trying to find out which live was that. It was when Lady Snoop and everybody was here.
You good, OC girl? You okay?
OC girl got to get her breath.
I'm fine. I'm on my way to work. I'm just pissed off because the nigga, I can't believe him. You bring them raggedy ass bitches up there, say, let them have a platform to talk on like that. They could never stand in my shoes, never. Them bitches can't burn a candle on one end of me. Fuck them hoes. And I said what I said, and I meant what the fuck I said. Give a fuck about them raggedy, deadbeat-ass bitches. They ain't got their fucking kids. Let them sit there and tell you all that dumb-ass shit. Get the paperwork, nigga. You find out for yourself. I saw saw the shit. I know what the fuck some hoes did. I know exactly what that bitch did. I heard it with my own ears talk to her kids like shit. I heard it.
And beating on her own. I bet you when he get that paperwork.
You're that hoe, the bitch that talked to her mama like that. She disrespected her mama yesterday up with all his family. You didn't hear that, nigga? You didn't hear that? So I'm supposed to respect her mother more than she respect her own mother? Get the fuck
and
out of here.
Got arrested for beating on her mother. Got arrested for it.
And the other bitch you got sent up there with you, she got her doxed her fucking grand, talking shit about her own, going to dox her grandmother. So they so disrespectful. What the fuck? You better do your motherfucking homework when you kind of stepping with some shit. You don't know what the fuck you talking about. Fucking dirty ass bitches, and you up there got them on your platform. The fuck is going on around this bitch? You upholding
first of
that
all,
bullshit.
Carol said she don't even like shit. Kids. Carol don't even like kids until they get of a certain age. She said she don't. Wow. She Carol said out her own mouth, out her own all mouth, right, to my ears.
So look,
she
so
said
hold on,
she don't like kids.
Let me show y'all this weak ass shit he did and why I said this is about VS. Because I had talked to him before this live. I talked to him. This is about his weird obsession for VS. So I had talked to him, right? I talked to him before this live, and he still gets up on the, I just watched this. And he says that I disrespected his platform. Like, nigga, you can't even keep a platform. I disrespected him on my platform. Nigga, you came over here and you saw, like...
I mean, you'll be crying. But if people can sum it up, you know. So, they really want, they can say it. I mean, it'll get dark, and you're going to be around here, you know.
Mind you, this is the type of conversation we was having, and here comes this nigga, and I'm looking like, I hope he doesn't try to come up here and be on no goofy shit, but as soon as he gets up there, he's sharing the screen, and I see it's the receipt that me and him already talked about, right? I had just talked to him before I went live, and I asked him kind of like, I don't really care about what VS got going on in the past, I just don't think she deserved for the traumas to be exploited for no reason, and I felt horrible about it because people was blaming me. So here come his bitch ass. And I'm like, okay.
Wearing, you know, carrying rosaries, but, you know, they went real dark.
Yeah.
We just kind of used to.
That's what she says. She say everybody's been molested. Everybody's been touched. Everybody's been raped. Everybody's kids been played with. It's just what it is. Hey, ZX.
That's not true. But even if it was, what does that have to do with you sitting up there saying?
Salute, queen. Salute.
All right, I've been talking for a sec, so I'm gonna mute because I see. I'm sorry, I didn't see you on my watch. Come up here.
Now show me the disrespect that happened. Show me the disrespect, y'all. Hold on.
Speak, and I'm just gonna listen to what y'all got to say. And again, thank you, me. I'm gonna stay up here though for just a second.
Hey, mama. Hey, mamas. You know. Hey. Can you share that screen back there real quick for me, please, ma'am?
Okay.
All right, make it full screen. Thank you. This is where I'm at with it when it comes to children. I don't have no pics. Chanel is trash. She's a piss poor mother. She's piss poor, but I ain't got no pics. We want to ignore, who we want to ignore. Right here is a receipt. Now I hate the bitch. I'm going to put a penis in baby L's mouth. Now that's VS, the icon.
Can I also ask why Chanel went live on VS, but ZX just called her a piss poor mother, also called her trash, but she's sitting on his panel saying, I don't have a problem with CX. Okay. Is this about who's? Oh, okay. Oh, God. ZX, you going outside with this one? But hey.
Now, that's a receipt of her talking about putting a penis in Fly Baby's daughter's mouth. We got a selective outrage. Selective.
I don't like Chanel. She ain't shit. I don't like Fly Babe. She ain't shit. Now, I don't like VS. She ain't shit. And I don't panel whore. You know, I usually just play the clouds when I come through here. But a receipt is a receipt.
I don't say nothing at all. I really want him to drop the fuck down. Y'all want to know my true feelings right now? Shut the fuck up. Why the fuck did you get on this motherfucking panel? That's what I'm thinking right now. That's what I'm thinking right now. I say nothing. I just said, I'm going to go on mute. Because hopefully...
And you still...
Ooh. Hopefully, this motherfucker will go somewhere really fucking soon. Because you came over there like the fucking hater you are.
See, now I love y'all. I respect y'all. And I'm not going to play in your face. I'm not going to play in your face. I'm not going to play no games. I'm going to tell you the truth.
Stop that right there. He respects us, he loves us, and he wouldn't play in our face. And he just disrespected us and played
in our face. He was playing in my face right here, and I knew that. I was on mute. I said nothing because I knew what he was doing. Do y'all think I'm stupid? Mink, that still don't take away from what was said about Fly Baby daughter, though? Oh, okay. VS, this is all about you. I just want you to know I took heed of what you said. I didn't know it was going to be this crazy, but for ZX to do this, this kind of hurt my feelings. But when I saw him do this for the third time, ZX, the third time you've done this. But before I went live again, I said, please don't do that live on VS. She's going through enough. Okay? She's going through enough. They're dragging her for no reason, speaking on her sexual traumas. Please don't do that. VS, I called him before I went live. OC girl called him, not on my watch, called him. But that, you understand? And just said like, hey, like you making it, like I'm. A lot of people are attacking me. Can you chill? He said, I get it, Mink, but don't fuck with ZX. VS, don't fuck with VS. I said, listen, yeah, VS, I know he's a small fry. I'm just saying that it just still hurt my feelings, you know? It did. So, but let's hear how he just 2 days ago loved and respected Mob Squad.
And the truth of the matter is that if we stand for nobody dragging kids, then it's anybody. Anybody can get it. I don't want to be friends with people. Not me. I don't want to be friends with people that talk about putting penises in children's mouth. Not me. Oh. I'm not going to overlook that. I'm not going to...
Every person that you have on your panel right now, I could find a clip of them saying that my son sucks dick. You have four women on your panel right now who loves to speak sexually about my son.
In my son as well.
And yeah, all of our children, ZX. The women that's on your panel that you said are great women over here that you are just rooting for. Yeah, they all have done that. They, as a matter of fact, they have, on your panel right now, you have 16 CPS cases and children taken out of the home. That's what you have. You have those kind of moms you have on your panel right now as we speak. You have prostitutes on your panel. Thank you. But anyway, we'll continue.
Get over that. I'm not going to ignore that because I need numbers. All right? I don't do that. That's not who I am. I love y'all.
I respect y'all. I rock with you.
You won't ignore that for numbers? Sir, what are you doing today? Oh, okay. All right. What are you doing today, ZX? You're ignoring it, right? Because you have Chanel, who you just said was a piss poor parent and mom and all that. You have her on your panel right now. Oh, okay. Oh, God. This is pretty bad, ZX. But, hey, what am I? But I ain't nothing but a hooker anyway.
It is what it is. But I hate, I really do hate fake people. I'm outraged.
Then you should hate yourself because you.
Man, God damn it, Snoop. Did she do a reading? Was that a reading? Because I don't even do readings and stuff like that, y'all. But is she a psychic? What the hell, Snoop? Got on my goddamn nerves last night, but this bitch, goddamn it, this fucking bitch, I couldn't stand her. Fucking bitch. Look at this shit. Look at this little fucking skinny little rascal. Fucking bitch. She got her little ass up there and said, what? Got on my goddamn nerves last night. This fucking little feisty fucking fucker. Fucking fucker bitch.
Y'all are smart shit.
Yeah, like, it's crazy.
Yeah, fucking. I need 10 seconds. Go ahead. Let me go on mute.
Wait a minute.
Suppose what?
I need to
be your son and take it. You nasty bitch. Have daughter's mouth. I'm not gonna play in your face. I'm not gonna play no games. I'm gonna tell you the truth.
And the truth of the matter is that if we stand for nobody, Dragon Kids, then it's anybody. Anybody can get it. I don't want to be friends with people, not me. I don't want to be friends with people that talk about putting penises in children's mouth. Not me. Oh. I'm not going to overlook that. I'm not going to skip over that. I'm not going to ignore that because I need numbers. All right? I don't do that. That's not who I am. I love y'all. I respect y'all. I rock with you. It is what it is. But I really do hate fake people. I'm outraged.
Then you should hate yourself because you want your motherfucking ass said that people that have children that are disabled are fucking cursed. So if they trash, bitch, you trash. I'm so tired of you motherfuckers with all this bullshit on this ass fucking app. But you ain't no better, my nigga. Who the fuck you talking to?
Going off on your skinny ass raggedy little bitch, you.
As the rest of them.
This is where we started to get cringy, and I didn't like it. However, what she said was, hey, let's go. Let's see what happened.
You ain't shit. You ignorant dumb bitch. You don't have a pussy, bitch. It drives the fuck up.
None of that. You ain't got no pussy, bitch. And don't nobody you understand that, hoe?
You dumb, ignorant fucking whore. You want respect? You give it. You fucking idiot. You dumb, skank, popsicle looking bitch. You don't get to come up.
Now, this is where I got secondhand embarrassment because he actually embarrassed himself. I just stayed on mute and he continued to embarrass himself. I didn't judge you for embarrassing yourself like this, ZX. But hey, let's point it out now. Since we're being fake, let's do it.
I'm up here and scream and holler at me like I'm supposed to what? Be your son and take it? You nasty bitch. You fucking whore. You, another bitch out here that been fucking YouTubers. You nasty skank bitch. Oh, yeah. Let's talk about your fiery little skinny ass.
It's about to get really bad. And the secondhand embarrassment I was having on that panel when he was embarrassing himself, sounding like a grandpa that needed to take his fucking medicine. Where did they fucking get him? What the fuck? Listen to it. He's talking about somebody's mom. Let me disrespect. It got so I was embarrassed. I was embarrassed. Like, I feel embarrassed. He embarrassed me. This was a fucking, I was fucking embarrassed.
Out here fucking Tommy Sotomayor, you nasty bitch. You lost to a fucking meth head. That's what the fuck you did. You lost to a meth head, you obsessed fucking whore. You obsessed fucking nut. You don't get to be a part of a conversation about children. You ain't made none. You nasty, retarded fucking man-looking bitch with a blonde wig. Shut the fuck up. Now, if I could regather myself, before ignorant bitch got on the panel, the point.
And it made me feel some type of way because I don't have no issue with Lady Snoop. So it was like, nigga, you putting me in a real situation. Like, we had a conversation before I went live. You did this, and it was just like, it was so like, nigga, you, like, I was so mad right here. Like, I was mad, but it gets worse. And I'm gonna tell you when it gets worse. And I almost got out of my motherfucking body. And I really held my composure and showed this bitch nigga as much respect as I possibly could hold within my soul without jumping out of my motherfucking skin.
Point that I'm trying to make is this, very simply. That was a receipt. That was a receipt. I ain't no hypocrite. That's how I rule. Period. All right. Now I'm gonna drop down and I'm gonna let you ladies continue to talk. All right. Y'all have a good day.
Okay, salute.
It's always a retarded bitch in the crew. Slick shade, dumb, thirsty bitch. I can't stand that shit. And then y'all say, look how he talk to women. Who the fuck is this little tramp bitch? Fuck her. Fuck.
Can someone insert a rolling eye? Because we were like, okay, nigga, when are you leaving? Like, when are you dropping down, nigga? Like, when are you dropping down? We're sitting here like you're overstaying your welcome at this point. I'm trying to be as, like, I'm like, this is so, like, I never have done this on this panel. Never disrespected his platform like that. Never. And you're seasoned, right? You're seasoned. You should know better. As an older man who's been on this motherfucker since 400 years, you should know better. This was ridiculous. It was disrespectful. It was rude. It was out of line. And I still didn't disrespect you one time. I didn't open my motherfucking mouth.
Not at all. Not
fuck at all. You, Snoop. You prune pussy having bitch. Your ovaries dried the fuck up. You can't carry a baby, bitch. Oh my God. Listen to what he's saying. You can't carry a bitch. You can't carry a baby.
Hold on.
You know why you can't?
So you don't like to be talking about kids, but we have people in our squad who can't have babies. So you brought your raggedy ass over here speaking on a women's platform. It's all pink over this motherfucker. And decided that you wanted to speak about women who are unable to have kids. You thought that was a good idea. It was respectful, knowing it's a whole bunch of new people here that I don't know. It doesn't know my platform. Oh, okay. Mm.
Can't carry a baby, huh? Because you weigh 90 pounds, bitch. A baby would kill you. It would suck you dry.
Come on, man. We're not finna just sit up here and let this man disrespect.
Oh, shut the fuck up.
First of all, Miss Mama Z,
shut the fuck up. You ignorant bitch.
Good afternoon, you everybody on the panel.
The moment Bless Holly stepped on there, you told her to shut the fuck up. Like, who the fuck are you, bitch, nigga? And I let that shit slide. But you did that to Bless Holly. And you switched it over to Ken. But that was highly disrespectful to one of my A1, day ones. You disrespected her for no reason. But she was right. We was allowing you to go way too far. But at this moment, I let you slide, hoping you just didn't know who she was. I let you slide. I dropped her down in the back. I told her in the back chat, hey, I just want to keep you down so I know exactly that he knows who he's talking to. I still didn't disrespect you. Normally, you would have got disrespected, but I gave you the benefit of the doubt that you was just out of your motherfucking mind.
This is all women talking about women.
Shut the fuck up,
baby mama. I don't know why you up here, grandma.
So if you notice right there, I dropped Bless Holly down. Because I didn't know what he was going to be doing. And I wanted to make sure that he knew. That he, and I said, I'm going to deal with ZX later. I'm going to call him later to let him know that he was talking to, like, Bless Holly. But I dropped her down. She was backstage at this point. And I kept her back there. And I'm like, So my Discord's going crazy. Like, this nigga said, did y'all hear what he just said to Bless Holly? Did y'all hear what he said to Bless Holly? They're going crazy. I went against my people, my A1, day ones, my people that have supported me since day one of me being on this app. To sugarcoat what you had just did. Because I'm like, he's out of his body. I don't feel like arguing with ZX on this panel right now. You never called and said, my bad, nothing. You disrespectful motherfucker. That's just who you are as a man. It doesn't take a woman to do anything to you. Bless Holly did nothing to you. She's one of the most supportive subscribers on this app. How dare you have any opinion on what the fuck is going on over here? And you could barely even keep your motherfucking channel. What you did was out of line. It was disrespectful. You should have minded your motherfucking business. Because anytime you have an issue, I mind my fucking business. But I know you're on a clout chase and your blood pressure so high because all of your enemies was on this platform. And still, when they asked me, do I fuck with ZX? Guess what? I still said, I don't have a problem with ZX. Because I'm not weak like that. Just because I'm in the face of your enemy, I don't have to fold and say, oh no, ZX did me some. Oh no, no. No, I'm not phony like that. I can stand on my own. Whether someone likes you or dislike you, I stand on my own. But this day, I was embarrassed to say it. It was hard for me to say it this day. And that's exactly why. Because you made a fool of yourself for no reason. You're a disrespectful old motherfucker. And my son would never grow up to be a bitch nigga like you. Because I will whip his ass. If my son ever spoke to a woman like you do, I would fuck him up. And that's the problem. Your mama didn't fuck you up. But that's what you needed. But that's why you grew up to be a bitch ass nigga. Bitch nigga, don't you ever in your motherfucking life threaten to spit in my motherfucking face unless you're ready to do that. Because you're one of the most bitch ass niggas on this motherfucker I've ever seen in my motherfucking life. And I gave you a pass, bitch nigga. But I'm glad you got you some numbers today, Grandpa. I'm going to call you Grandmama. Grandmama ZX. Because I hit your panel today. And just like the rest of them bitch ass niggas, you were scared. In fact, you called me a bitch. I ain't never call you out your name a day in my motherfucking life.
Never.
Never. So, I don't have to drag your children. I ain't got to drag your mama. She already got you as a son. That's a drag in itself to say, hey, there go my son, ZX, the bitch ass nigga. I wish the fuck my son would.
Goon,
this happened 2 days ago. Goon, this happened the day before yesterday. The day before yesterday.
All right, boom, bitch, you old bitch. Now shut the fuck up.
I could tell you, I was listening to this and I was like, this shit is like, I was right now, this was probably 15 minutes of agony. I was pissed. I was really like, I was boiling. Do you understand me? And I'm just like, let Lady Snoop go. Like, I ain't say nothing. But he said, I disrespected him on my platform. Reese D said I was on fire. He got on his platform and said, I disrespected him on my platform, What the fuck did he deserve? What the fuck did he deserve? What the fuck did he, what did he deserve? Are you kidding me? Cool and get off. Demon time. Come in, come back to me. Where Coolin at? What's she doing?
Children have autism. I never want them women to think that they're cursed because their babies got fucking autism. Or their babies have some kind of disability. Fuck him! I'm saying, I'm not saying, bitch, one second, because the same motherfucker he thought he was gonna use against me, he was sitting up getting paid for and selling off any crackhead bitch ass bitch. Don't ever fucking bring no hoes up to me, nigga. Show me what you doing on your own, you bitch ass nigga, other than getting in women business, because that's all the fuck you do. We're not even gonna talk about how you disrespect women that go through sexual motherfucking assault. Fuck that nigga, off with his motherfucking head. And anybody got a problem with it, what's poppin'?
Can you stop it right there, B? Please.
Go ahead, Ms. Beachy. How you doing?
Oh, and hey, Snoop, you came up in here like...
Pause, not B. The reason why would she say that...
You see me, but hold on, real quick. But, y'all see me and not on my watch are on mute the entire time. This is one of the most uncomfortable positions to be in when you fuck with both feet.
I was in shock, but when she just sat up there and said about women in the sexual assault, right? I just want to play 5 seconds of this to show what was said that morning, speaking of women and sexual assault, from Chanel, the person you had on your panel.
No, I got 10 motherfucking minutes. Then when I get off at 4:30,
I just want to play this.
On my way home, I'm going live again, bitch. I'm doing a motherfucking marathon on this old raggedy-ass bitch. I want to talk about her breeding-ass motherfucking mama, why she let her daddy fuck her all in her mouth and in her fucking ass. Why she let her brother fuck her in her mouth and fuck her in her ass, bitch. Where the fuck was your motherfucking mama at, bitch? Why your daddy and your brother was fucking on you, bitch? Let's talk about Stockholm Syndrome, hoe. Because ain't none of mine has been violated, bitch.
I just wanted to play that real quick. Since you were talking about somebody's mother, that Chanel that was just on your panel spoke about, and the sexual assault that had happened with VS. I just wanted to point that out since Lady Snoop pointed that out.
But he actually got that from what I heard. ZX had just did it the day before.
Oh, wow. I didn't even know that. I just know that's what she said. Like, you know what I mean? About VS.
Do you remember what Coolin said in the chat before? And she said it was a 14 minutes. He was going in on VS. And you were like, no. But, hey, Coolin may be a psychic too.
She may be. I just thought of that. Let me go on mute. Absolutely.
This is Sparta.
Fuck okay. He talking to. As got women, they disrespect us way too much. But why didn't sit there and watch that nigga play off in motherfuckers? Trauma, as y'all call it now, playing off these women and they
children. No, those are not my words. That. He came up with that, and people, you know, people are wrong with stuff, but they really playing like I don't. You gotta be careful what you say, and see, like, even like he showed that receipt. Yeah, it was tacky. It was distasteful, and in the heat of the moment, you said some shit that, oh my god, where the hell that come from? I done some shit like that too. Maybe not in the same context. And
hold on one second. Holy mother, don't ask me about no fucking nobodies. I'm Lady Snoop TV. So if they motherfucking subs ain't subbing next to mine, don't ask me about no fuck ass nobodies. I run this shit. Don't ask me about a motherfuck thing.
Well, I just feel I want to make sure people hear it is okay. I have been wanting the same live said something about somebody's child. You know, and it was mean as hell. And in the same live, said, hold on, I'm not going to leave up off of here without saying, y'all, that was tacky. I could have came with something else. Okay, that was tacky. So I'll let you know, as a woman, you know, I said, I don't fuck with you, I don't like your ass. But there, I could have did better than that. And then make sure it was heard again. So I don't know why people act like once you do something, you stuck with that shit forever. And people don't, you know, it's some of us that are like, no, it was in the moment. And it was, you know, we were talking about You're not going to trigger her with that. You are not
fucking drag that.
But that's pretty much what happened that day as far as that is concerned. But that was so, that was like embarrassing. And it was rude. It was like,
I was in shock.
Mm-hmm.
And another thing I want to say too, to ZX too, anytime anybody would speak on ZX, anytime, I would either check them, jump off the panel, or if not jump off the panel, leave the chat. So I was sitting up there respectful and loyal, even if he was not around, because that's what type of person I am. That's what type of people we are. Go ahead, Meek. I just wanted to say that real quick.
No, I just, that's just that like.
I see. I couldn't say anything because I was like, what the fuck?
And then here come cooling ass. I appreciate it, but
I was like, no. I said, cooling is tripping. You know, I was saying, cooling is tripping. That ain't what happened.
No, I was trying to be like, look, be quiet. I wanted you to be quiet because that shit was dead ass wrong.
Yeah.
Oh no, VS. It ain't nothing about that. Look at this. You might not have seen. Did you see his live earlier? VS? You must not have seen his live. You must not have seen his live.
Yeah, VS. His live was real disrespectful towards me and the squad.
You must not have heard his line.
It was Mink.
Listen.
You don't. I might dabble in
it. Oh.
But to sit up on a fucking 8-hour stream and say, I was talking about Toya, but the other seven fucking hours. We don't like Queen 88.
You don't know what Queen 88 said about our kids being fucked in the ass and everything and sucking dick?
You get to come in my shit and talk shit.
He blocked all of us.
Say bad. Nothing.
Listen.
No, it's going to be triggered.
Hold on.
What did Skoka say bad? Nothing. She was trying to tell VS, leave it. Oh, nobody caught that part.
ZX, I don't give a fuck if you strike me. I will beat it. I'm not you, nigga. She said, what did Skoka say bad? Let me play you some things that Skoka said bad. I don't give a fuck. Let's go over some things that Skoka said bad. Let's listen.
I'm on mute.
He said he don't care. Once he saw y'all over in my hood, it was, yeah, I know. Let's hear some things Skoka had to say. But she lied.
It just sounds so deep. Like I'm gonna deny it. So now you go to my pretty ass daughter.
Which didn't happen.
My son death day is sick to face. I will kill bitches and their kids. Listen, let me clear my voice so y'all can hear it again. I will kill them bitches and their kids. You hear me? Ever put my 1-year-old daughter on your motherfucking live at the face.
She
will kill the face. I will kill bitches and their kids. Listen, let me clear my voice so y'all can hear it again. I will kill them bitches and their take it.
Wait, y'all beef with you? Now you don't do that, but so this 2022, so we get a little petty sometimes, just a little bit. Sometimes we want to come down there and kick on the peasants and stuff. Yeah, sometimes it's needed, you know, sometimes you have to keep them in their place. Because when you start getting people real information, then on the low behind the scenes, they want to squash your shit. And they want to make it seem like they really don't have beef with you. Now you don't really have beef with me and it's not that serious to you because I have your address. Because I know where you at.
Because your mama still work at that post office. The package.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I forgot y'all. So innocent. Let me go back to the.
Yeah, go back to the.
Yeah, I gotta go to the one where she said. Oh. She over here lying. This is what Chanel did to her daughter, and she said, "I did it."
Now you don't do that.
This is. This is what Chanel did to her daughter.
So now you go to our pretty ass daughter with hope. My son death day is six pedophile. I said your son sucked dick. Like I'm gonna deny. I said it. Your son sucked dick. What did you talk about? My son death day is 6 days away. And you up here posting my kid like they for sale.
Look, crying because you was lying. Nobody posted her kid. But she sure did say my son was sucking dick and lying on my child. An 8-year-old boy.
And she's going to kill all of them.
Yeah, all of them bitches.
You hear that, ZX?
Over and over again. That's Scocahontas. Innocent, I didn't do shit. Scocahontas. Innocent, I never said nothing, Scocahontas. Don't make me go to the other videos if you don't think I have them, bitch, because I do. Sitting up here pretending because you put something on private, bitch, that you didn't do it. Queen 88 did the same.
Queen 88 did the same.
So, but for those people who wonder why their kids got posted, she kept saying I posted a kid and I didn't. She kept calling my son gay. But when I found pictures of her children, her oldest son was in rainbow. So you motherfucking right, I posted it. Because you're putting your traumas of your child, because your Scoca's son was in rainbow. He had a rainbow shirt on. He had a rainbow bracelet on. But she keep calling my son gay, my 8-year-old. But her oldest son is out here rocking rainbow.
It says she's gonna kill our kids. Kill us.
We said that part. We can't keep saying that part. We said it.
Oh, I'm gonna repeat it because I want to make sure everybody understands.
Ill part. We got it, but you can't say it like that. You just gotta say ill.
Ill. Let's go.
Yeah. So I don't give a So you want me to care and give respect to these bitches? I can't. I mean,
let me clear my voice so y'all can hear it again. I will kill them bitches and their kids. You hear me? Bitch, don't you ever put my 1-year-old daughter on your motherfucking live.
We didn't. Nobody put your daughter on the live, honey. Lies. That was a lie.
Where's the receipt, Skoka? There isn't one because you lied.
Yeah, but you know, I'm just appalled at this point, but yeah, have a good time over there, ZX. there would never be like, no, oh, my bad, clear it up. Hell no. Never.
Nah, ain't no clearing this up. It's a wrap.
Have a good time with those loyal, respectful women over there.
Like, oh, you said this and you told me all your business. I don't care what anybody told you about my fucking business. I don't care because actually the business that anybody think they know about me, I can tell it myself.
They don't
have no shame in my game because all these motherfuckers on here is rich as fuck. I'm the broke bitch on this motherfucker. I don't give a fuck. All y'all rich as fuck. Bubbles or nothing. I'm going to keep it real with you.
That's what's up. Yeah, I love meeting new people.
You don't even know what to say.
It's hard to make a connection. You know, I like good people. That's it. Good people, you know, grown people. Like, I'm not into the screaming, the hollering, the cussing. I mean, I do that. But I don't generally like to do it. But, you know, I don't like to get into all of that. link now, please. Who is Queen? Do you know who that is?
That's 88. She wanna get up here. I'm not gonna do all that fucking yelling.
Oh, okay.
I'm local. Fuck all this. Only
if y'all could be respectful, Queen. 88. I'll let you come up. And good pussy lady is back here. This is my first time talking to Miss Green.
Well, I hope you had a good time, ZX. I don't have to link up with people's apps to make a point. I still respected you, and the people that you did not like, I still respected you. But you can die slow now, bitch. I don't give a fuck about you. I actually feel relieved. Now I don't have to say, when somebody asks me, do I fuck with ZX? I don't have to say like, yeah, I do.
You don't gotta just tiptoe no more around these YouTube streets. Because if it was left up to him, we wouldn't be acquainted with nobody.
Yep, I feel great. Thank you, Kimmy, for giving me that advice. Way back then, I always told Not On My Watch what you said. She can attest to that you made a very good point that we were limiting ourselves from fucking with ZX. And I kept that in mind, Buddy Lee. I kept everything you said in mind as well. Lady Live, Queen, everybody. Like, I kept all of that in mind. I never took what he said and judge any of you for it. And I hope you never take anything that anybody else said and judge me for it. Because I'm right here if you got questions for me. I never
and
had
they've
anything.
All said that. And
I've never had any questions for you all. I didn't stay away from your chats. I still came around. I still showed my love, respect, or whatever. Never had no issues with nobody behind that nigga. I would never do that. I never judged. I didn't judge nobody because of him. But it's fuck him forever.
Well, yeah, after he talking about spitting in your face, that nigga's a dub. Like, talking about.
VS, even VS too. Who else? Like, everybody, anybody. But look at you. Look at you. You don't give a fuck, you desperate-ass old bastard. Look at you. Desperate. Talking about I needed attention. The fuck you call that? I can add anybody I want. That's what I do on my community posts. I add people. What happened?
I don't know. They're shaking the table. So I'm going down.
Everybody's saying, glad y'all learned who ZX really is. I sure did. I'm sure his desperate ass to be going live 100 million times about nothing.
Yeah, you're right, Miss Claudia. He a clown.
I want to tell VS so bad. I'm not gonna say it. She don't know how to build credit though, VS. Damn. She don't got good credit, BS. She had to pay $11,000 down on a $12,000
car. $11,000. That's crazy.
Like, I just want to be like, BS, this lady does not have, she don't know shit about credit. Like, she's a scammer. Alert. But then they're going to be like, man, I'm going to say what the fuck I want to say. That bitch ain't got no good credit, VS. The fuck? She paid $11,000 to buy here, pay here. Shit. She don't know. She don't even know, but she said credit score. That bitch don't even, that bitch don't own shit. She can't even get an apartment.
Fuck. No, you got to let them find out.
Let me let y'all find it. No, I'm not. That bitch can't, them people can't even get apartments.
Who Kim said on a pre-owned car?
$11,000 down on a $20,000 car. What the fuck is she teaching anybody? She don't even got a bank account. Mink, you is his boss now. You're gonna make ZX go live. You go big pimping. I'm not making him go live. You give a fuck about him. Mink is all a play for attention. The fuck? This nigga is mad.
Right. Bless Holly. Mob Squad don't care about numbers like that. Like, it's just, it's not a real, like, big number game. They do too much looking at how many views you made on one video or how many people you got in one chat. Yeah, I understand you want your subscribers and stuff to go up, but y'all think this is, like, I don't know. Then y'all be having stuff to go along with these wrenches. Does the wrench pay your rent? The way y'all be arguing.
Yeah, I don't care if he flags. That was my content. What is he going to do? He can flag all he wants. Flag away. He say he going to play a recording. Who cares? Play a recording, like ZX. Like, you're weird. You too old for that shit.
So, like the girls are fighting, and the girls are Zia. Audio.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Catch that one with cream, bitch. I'm ready to bite motherfucking out, bitch, and I'm out of this motherfucker by my motherfucking self. I ain't got nobody in motherfucking. Wait, bitch, where about y'all motherfucking self? Y'all need to get y'all priorities together. Get your motherfucking babies, bitch. And you trying to have another one?
Bitch. You dropped the link for Reese.
Shit. I heard the nigga you trying to have a baby with still ain't came out. Keep pushing the day back, bitch. You nasty ass hoe. You a nasty ass bitch. You ought to be ashamed of yourself. You fighting custody for your babies and shit. And bitch, you got your nasty ass on this motherfucker trying to fuck every nigga that hit the motherfucking link, hoe.
Yeah, that's who ZX is rooting for. Good job, ZX. Great job.
He's going to be turned off by 88 in about 15 minutes because she don't know how to keep her dirty mouth off of people's children in the bed. So, yeah. He's going to be regretting his decision real soon.
Who cares? Fuck him. She'll be dragging him by next week. So, I think Cream would actually be... Yeah. We don't... Who cares?
No one.
This should be hilarious.
You too, Messy, said they over here for good.
Ass bitch. Funky cock hoe. Shit. This nigga invite me to his motherfucking channel to see if I was with whatever was going on between Chanel and Meek and all that bullshit, get my opinion. Then I get my motherfucking phone call.
Bitch, you ain't Scodane, ho. Bitch, you ain't Scodane, bitch. Call it the cream team, bitch. You ain't Scodane, bitch. When you out here doing bullshit, bitch, you know what? You about to debunk right now. Dang, because this was on, but
her slow ways gotta get up here.
I actually thought today was Sunday. On YouTube, ho. I don't fuck with Sco in real life, bitch. I wish Sco would fuck with you, bitch. So you can stop fucking with everybody else, bitch. I am fucking over happy, bitch. Over happy, bitch.
Oh, God. This is ridiculous.
Oh.
Them fighting is...
What? Bullshit, bitch. You know what? You ain't motherfucking Sco Gang, bitch. You operating under motherfucking cream team, bitch. The weakest team on this motherfucking board, ho. Because, bitch, if you a Sco Gang and you a Sco Thang and you a Sco Woman, bitch, you mad at me because I got a motherfucking nigga, really. That much you must be mad about, bitch, because Sco ain't my motherfucking nigga, bitch.
Finally. Sco Mysterious finally got a nigga. Jesus. ZX always changes who he support if you don't dislike who he does. Oh, okay. Is that what it is? Well, I'm grown. I do what the fuck I want to do. And I let people show me who they are. And everybody you warned me about, you were the person to do it. Mm-hmm. So, fuck you. Mm-hmm. Fuck yeah. It's really funny to me. It's actually funny, like, the way he was warning us, like, Mig, 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 Mig. I know you. I know, sweetheart. I know. And you turned out to be the one to do it. Like I said, you have no way to judge how I choose to react to people disrespecting my child. Because I didn't judge how you reacted when they did that, whatever, what they did to your child. How dare you, bitch? How dare you? How dare you? But hey, I don't have to disrespect your child to get my point across. Oh God, cooling and creaming fighting. Wait, 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 where? Okay, hold on. Shit. Fuck. This is too much. Do I need to stay live because it's too much going on?
Who's in the chat?
She called.
But when I was about to hit the panel, I got a phone call. And then, you know, I've been on the phone a long time. So when I got off, it was over. But I was getting messages talking about Mysterious and 88 is up there talking about me and I talk about kids. Is this you, Coolin?
You know it's me, ho. Don't buy your mind's hate. And yes, I do call you Lock Legs.
I know what you call me. That shit don't bother me. What's up?
What's up with you?
Why can Coolin call everybody their nickname, though? That's not fair. Coolin can call everybody their nickname, and no matter where she goes. Ain't that crazy? Ain't that crazy?
Coolin's a boss in her own way.
Back into the center of the situation so you can jump on her. What's the difference?
You're sick as fuck, Coolin, because if that was the plan, why the
girl, shut the fuck up, you dirty ass. Nobody even talking to you.
You're being funny, bitch. You need to be prepared.
Dirty turban, mustard ass.
Now, what the fuck is this child at? This was your face. You were going.
did you call a town room shaker that? Because you've been. Yeah, man, what killed me about these bitches is when y'all in the motherfucking face, where do this energy be? That's mysterious, too. Yeah, I know. In your motherfucking face, why you didn't say you gonna drag my daughter if I put her on her snowsuit again, bitch? Why did you call a town room shaker that?
Now they talking about it. They just was on there talking about dragging it. Yeah, now the title fucks Go Game because she needs BS. It's hilarious.
Because you bitches know what the fuck going on. I slept peaceful. Bitch, I ate peacefully. I drank.
Hello, Craig. What's going on?
Salute, salute, salute. I'm trying to find this live. But which, don't call it, got two pages.
He blocked me, so I don't
this
know.
Is. Oh, God.
Like, who? Uzi, we don't really get to say too much. Let me see. And this is going to be my last time saying this. Uzi, we don't really get to say too much. Let me see.
Girls, come on, Mr. These are.
Let's talk about it. Y'all can have fun reading this. We're going to talk. I'm going to post all this stalking ass shit.
Girl, y'all, how many times she going to post these same messages from Green?
Like who? Adam. And you teach because people going to look at the man thinking like, oh, he won't even help you. You know, he won't even give you a breadcrumb due to your broke ass out here, due to your ass out here with nowhere to go, nothing to do, no cars to drive. So you really make it bad on the man. So the man can't even really.
I can't believe Mysterious. She on Mysterious. She on Cream again. Like this is. I can't believe she said she show her chest to ZX to change the subject on other panels. Girl, she got time away.
What?
Now. Wait, who?
She showed her chest to ZX to chase the.
Wait, who's that up there? Oh, Reese.
We need to look at Reese. She went from the frog to a pimp.
That's magic, Don Juan.
Hey, y'all. I didn't even interrupt y'all.
We know who Magic Don Juan is in the green suit.
The one that used to be with Snoop Dogg.
I want to say a couple words about ZX and his pimping capabilities. Fuck that. He wanted to utilize my doctor's degree on his panel, and I refused to let him do so. So after he found out I was a doctor, I never went back on his panel again. I don't like users, and I could already tell he was a user. And I don't like the way he talked, the way he talked about women, the way he talked to women, talk about women's ovaries. What is going on? Absolutely not. I have nothing else to say about that man. That man is ridiculous. And after he did what he did, I'll never go back to his panel. I don't care if everybody else fell back in love with him. That man is deeply sick and too old to be doing what he's doing. So I wish him the best of luck with the hoes on the other side, because he fit right in with his pimp outfit.
Right.
I mean, come on, you guys. The stuff that he said to Lady Snoop.
Yeah, that was crazy.
I mean, do you know how many people he offended in that chat? Then he said that people with kids with disabilities got.
Lady Devereaux said today ZX was officially introduced to the real hookers he's always talking about.
Yeah.
He always want to have grown-up conversation. He always want to make everybody feel comfortable to go on his panel.
I would have thought it would have been a grown conversation. I really would have, you know, expected that a grown conversation. And I know my internet was going in and out and didn't get an opportunity to say what I wanted to say, but once those hookers got up on there, it was over.
And what is he doing? He's taping conversations like a female. So who is he, Queen 88? Now he got a tape.
Girl.
Well, he did say Carol was like his daughter, so you know, like father, like
daughter.
But
when he said Carol was like his daughter, what he said 3 days ago about how sick and disgusting she was, did he forget about that? I mean, I'm just trying to figure out, do these people not read history books? Are these people just dumb all the way around? Did you forget what you said?
But what I'm saying is, why didn't Carol go live on ZX? He outright said that about her. Why do you think that Carol didn't go live on ZX, did go live on VS? It wouldn't make sense, right?
This is weird.
It doesn't make sense. Coolin, can you ask? They trying to take the heat off Toya. Yeah. So I just asked you guys because he outright called her a deadbeat mom. He doesn't like her. VS just asked the question. So why didn't Carol go live on her? On him? Because it didn't. Well.
I was listening this morning and she said ZX has never said anything negative about me.
I know.
She said it, and I wanted to make sure he didn't take that video down. Because, so I did a little screen recording. ZX has never said anything negative about me. And I've never said negative things about him. And that's a lie too.
Yeah, I know, because it was several times she wanted to go live with him. We said no.
That's a lie too. So it's just like in this sector, I don't really like it because no one remembers what they say. They just say whatever, and then tomorrow they act like they never said it. And then when you pull up the receipt, you the problem.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That
just like Skok is finna be sitting up here crying. Now that Mink pulled that receipt back out the hat. She thought it was gone because she put it on private. But I keep saying, and y'all don't pay attention, is just because you put it on private, Skoka, doesn't mean that Mob Squad don't have it in the Rolodex. I keep on telling y'all, we stay with receipts.
And we don't do snippets. So if you do
no, we don't video, do snippets.
We do screen recordings with date categorization. We have your crap. So you can stop lying and praying that it's not there because it's there. And no, mm-hmm. Don't worry. We're not going to run out of space. We got a whole Google Cloud for you, boo. Don't worry about that.
Yeah, she thought that I'll kill them bitches and their kids was disappeared. She thought it was ghost. No, no, no. We got it. Along with your nasty, disgusting 3-hour live that you was sitting up there talking about people's children in. A whole panel full of pedophiles. Then you act like, oh, I never doxed Mink. Shay, I never doxed Mink. And what did Mink pull up today? Y'all sitting up there doxing her. Who that works at the post office?
Uh-huh. It was a very poor dox. Very, very mm-hmm. poor.
But they said they never did it, though. Just because you put it on private Skokahannis, Smokahannis, Crackahannis, Robin, whatever you want to call yourself, that does not mean that we don't have it. We have it. And we're going to keep popping on y'all shit. Because y'all too dumb to realize that we're very smart and intelligent. Smarter than y'all.
Smart enough to go to the dentist.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
What we missing?
Oh, we know I love and cool and get her ass. Let's go.
Let's go cool and
shit. Hold on, y'all.
You know,
I'm gonna drive back down in the chat, y'all. Right.
But they telling me, they talking to me, that nigga talking to me, and she timing them out. Oh, hating ass bitch. Whoever don't have a ring, I hate you.
That bitch here, everybody motherfucking leg and talk about Chanel. Now she in your motherfucking chat trying to dictate. I'm off this bitch. I can't fuck with no man. Yeah,
y'all don't.
Dirty bitch ass.
Cool and no kids.
Oh, no. Mm-mm-mm.
minute, a bitch wanna run? Now you just said all of that, bitch. Bring your no-kid, nicky booty ass. No. Bring your herpy recipient having ass. Bring your no-kids having ass. Bring your dirty bitch ass.
Una, no kids.
Y'all, this bitch is fake as a motherfucker. Do you hear me? They right. have said, girl, cool it, no kids. Coolin gonna drag. Ooh. Mm. She put Coolin backstage.
We ain't talking about kids.
Bitch, just sit over here and drag me, my children, and some more shit. No, I said, bitch ain't had no kids. I didn't talk about her motherfucking kids. Back the fuck up here, and I can time out who the fuck I want to time out. That's why I got a motherfucking ring. I don't jeopardize your motherfucking page. This bitch came over here timing all kind of motherfuckers because they was talking shit to her. Do you remember? Do you remember? No motherfucking play with me, Mysterious, about no motherfucking rich or that bitch. You don't even know that. Ain't you just saying that that's your motherfucking friend? You
fucking play with me, Mysterious. You're working on our stuff. We doing something.
You need to work on that bitch. That bitch need to work on that motherfucking ass to CVS and get that motherfucking ointment. But that motherfucking herpy buffs and outbreaks that
motherfucking. You get your raggy ass, bro. You want to fuck with my kid, go ahead. You raggy motherfucker. Bitch, you ain't got one on. Bitch, your motherfucking ass. Bitch, you ain't got one. Bitch, you over to this motherfucker. Hey, get your motherfucking herpy on your knee. You raggy motherfucker. What the fuck you gonna do about it, bitch? What you gonna do about it, bitch?
Let's see if she drops Chanel. She said, fuck you and your kids. Now she cool with Max. Mm. She need help.
Take down the screenshot, Mysterious. My head.
Ew. Ew. Cool and put a baby daddy up. She. Ew. Like, I be like, ew, because you know she, like, you know, like, you know she got herpes, so I'll be like, that's what herpes is like. I don't know. Cool got called a smooth child. Oh, nigga, bitch. Oh, nigga. That is not the wrong nigga. That is your nigga. She still don't want to claim Carlos. We didn't got his prescriptions and everything. This bitch said,
"Father, baby, wrong nigga, bitch. No,
that is him." She keep on saying, "It's not her baby daddy." Oh God. Nobody editing no pictures, bitch. Girl, that's your husband, bitch. She letting her call the kids bitches.
I thought she told Coolin no kids though.
No, you didn't, Chanel.
You're a negative. Get out of here and say you're a negative motherfucker. What that means? time talking about shit.
Colin's about to drag somebody way back.
So yeah, I'll let you.
Wow. Well, that's ZX's new friends. Yeah, that's ZX's daughter's talking.
Right, look at Lady D said, look at your daughter.
That's ZX's daughter.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
He yep. should be so proud.
Great job.
With the fucking pack of animals you got.
Hey, Ajitin. Great live, ZX. Well, Kool's gonna be dragging stories really soon. What y'all think?
IGT, not on my watch. IGT, not on my watch. IGT said, "Cool, cool," and tell her to turn her mic up. She need her mic turned up. She's too low. We need Cool in the scratch, like she scratched.
Yeah.
Okay.
Any bitch on YouTube you think won't scold, bitch, you go at them, hoe. Or you try to do that. See, bitch, you can't sun me, bitch. I fuck with scold, bitch. Cool, man. Shut the fuck up, bitch. I ain't going no motherfucking way, you raggedy naked motherfucker. Now do me something, bitch. She ain't got for the motherfucking thing, bitch. I said what the fuck I said, hoe. Now do something, you naked motherfucker. Do something, you naked motherfucker.
Chanel got her stuttering?
I know. Y'all do that. That make me fuck up what I'm doing.
Okay, keep going.
What y'all saying and shit.
We got your back. You said you left off with you don't fuck with Skull.
Yeah, because you remember what the bitch said, and that makes me know that this bitch trying to put a dent in my shit, what I got going on.
Trying to put out a narrative out there.
Exactly. Uh-huh. And I'm going to put the truth out here. So when people come up, whether if y'all my friends and y'all get into it with each other, y'all should have enough respect for me to do this because remember, I'm only supposed to be on this bitch.
Right. That's why we got to hurry up because you'll get in trouble.
No, my motherfuckers say something about my motherfucking kids. I'm going to say whatever the fuck I want to say. Period. I'm going to say what the fuck I want to say. I don't give a fuck.
No,
that's fuck, negative bitch. So let's go. Let's go.
That's how y'all motherfuckers letting her friend y'all. Stupid motherfuckers. Totally. But y'all scared of the bitch. All of y'all scared of the bitch. And then y'all want to be like, then y'all say, Mink, oh my God, why'd you disrespect her?
Scary. Okay, they said VS played in your face and she little girled you yesterday, right? What the fuck is Carol doing to these people right now? She is sunning Sco Mysterious on her own panel. She is sunning her. She is little girl in her. What will 88 call it? Little Bow Wow?
All of them allow her to do it. All of them allow her to do it. When I got a buck back at the bitch, y'all look at me like I'm crazy. That bitch will never talk to me like that. Fuck
right, CB. They be bullying the shit out of Sco Mysterious. On her own goddamn panel. She's so goddamn. Oh gosh.
Let me tell you this. She ain't go to the video where Queen called me a bitch or something like that. Go see how y'all better be scared of that bitch. Y'all some weak ass hoes. Scared. And then get on this motherfucker and say I'm wrong. And say I'm wrong. Bitch. Get on this bitch and say I'm wrong. Go ahead. The audacity of these bitches to make a video and say I'm wrong.
I just can't believe the way Chanel do. I could believe it because she's been sunning them the whole time she's been over there. Calling them all types of bitches and doing all types of, and they all laughing it off. And she ain't laughing it off. She's serious about how she talks to y'all. She disrespect y'all on her own panels, and y'all laugh it off. Where they do that at? Fuck type Tommy. Mm-mm.
I wish the fuck I would.
I wish I would let Chanel talk to me the way she talked to them.
That's why I don't have no respect for nobody who can't stand up to that bitch. Fuck you and anything you represent.
Fuck all of them over there is scared of Chanel. Everybody who don't come at Chanel when she do something wrong, they all scared of her. All of them. So nobody likes to tell Chanel, oh, she's wrong.
She is to y'all. Maybe y'all won't keep playing with me. Because y'all like to play with me, and then when I go off, y'all get mad.
CC Life, you know she couldn't come over here acting a fool on D's panel. You already know Mink not having that. Mink put her in check. She was on mute when she was on the panel.
Oh, you in trouble? What did he say? It's going to be worth it because at the end, bitch, I'm going to put all your shit out here today.
Who says lies? All y'all scared of me.
Cool it. Y'all coming up here?
Kink, shut up.
If y'all fuck with me, see how we just chilling? Let me get this out because this is.
Well, if you just tried to railroad you saying you was talking shit about me, fuck that maggot ass bitch. That bitch is dusty and she motherfucking through, bitch. And don't nobody want no motherfucking book, you dumb bitch. Fuck alone. I fucked with you, but I
don't
give a fuck. That bitch put in your chat, she got me blocked. I hit the link and told you she blocking your supporters
because
they're talking to me. That's what the fuck I said. So, why you ain't let Max stay up here and get that bitch this work? No,
Max, when Max, they said they have paperwork on each other. So,
girl, so what? So what? That maggot ass bitch
put
up with my fucking mouth.
Get
this motherfucking work. Long the fuck
up with that bitch. You can't be up here when you got paper. You can't be up here when you got paper. That's all I'm saying, bitch. You know, you don't know who Mysterious is. Just stalking her throughout the damn and all this and that.
This is ridiculous. Today, bitch. This is ridiculous. I'm waiting on Wednesday too. We don't care nothing about that. They're cool and get back up there.
As a content creator, Yellinator, I don't feel like you should have to be explaining how you be running your platform. It's your platform. You tell people how you know what it is and what it ain't. And if they don't abide by it, then they don't come.
Y'all thought I was done. Oh, I'm most definitely done. But one thing you ain't gonna do, I ain't never really had a chance to say nothing about this raggedy bitch sour cream. I ain't never really had a chance to say nothing about it because dude, for scope, we always try to be, you know what I'm saying? But that shit out the door. I got a man who I have to motherfucking respect and bow down to and check in with, bitch. Bitch. See, ho, you bitch checking in with motherfuckers that can't even buy you no cereal, bitch, and ain't because you talk too much. Disloyal assholes. Stalking ass bitch. Here comes some more receipts, y'all. What was this one? Oh, bitch. That power fucker. Oh, this one, you trying to be a bitch friend when you want something. Yeah, when you want something, bitch, let me add the new ones up. The new ones is going to be even better. Let me get this video to knees, too. ZX is a man that's, you know what? I really don't know. They just told me to go over there. And I just went over there and it was nice. He was talking to us and everything. He was talking to us and everything. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't a bad thing. And don't get it twisted talking about, oh, you talk about Chanel with me and Chanel. Me and Chanel have lots of differences. Y'all have to listen to this.
Y'all got a difference right now.
Yeah. Let us publicly say. Chanel started off as Queen's friend. One thing y'all never understand about real friends and real bitches is we have to talk. Yeah, y'all asked, yes, he was good. We have to talk behind the scenes to each other. Like, we talked to Chanel mom yesterday. We have to talk into a better, you know.
Girl, we all talk to Chanel mother. Chanel, you don't run anything YouTube. CB, where's the unfit? Of course, he's going to try to call. He's going to talk to y'all. You can definitely tell who rode the short bus. Who? Oh, yeah. I know what you're saying now. Y'all, I'm ready to get off here. I'm tired. Bowing down to a man because he got money. This loyalty is fine. Definitely. But I'm ready to get off here. Yeah. I'm tired. I got stuff I got to do. It's Monday. I got to get on my truck, getting fixed, see what the hell is going on. But I'll be back. I'll be back a little later.
All right, talk to y'all later.